A research team at the UCT Center for Transport Studies is investigating the possibility of developing short sea shipping in the SADC region. Short sea shipping is an alternative form of commercial transportation that utilizes inland and coastal waterways to move commercial freight from major domestic ports to its destination. In such a system, we could consider a typical shipment of a container within the envisioned short sea shipping setting as follows. A container will be picked up from the shipper's premises by a land-based mode and transported over a considerable short distance to a seaport and then loaded onto a ship from where the container is transported by sea for the major part of the transport leg. At the destination port, the container is unloaded, cleared, and then transferred to a land-based mode for delivery at the consignee's premises. The actors in the freight procurement chain typically involves the shipper, the carrier, and the receiver. The shipper buys the service from the carrier, which is typically to transport a shipment between a certain origin to destination pairing. Now imagine this system operating in the SADC region. The SADC region covers over 5 million square kilometers with a coastline spanning over 14,000 kilometers. The SADC region was formed to achieve economic growth, development, peace, and security. It strives to achieve these objectives by alleviating poverty and reaching for regional integration whilst in line with democratic principles and sustainable development practices. SADC faces a number of problems in the freight transport sector, which in part will be addressed by introducing short sea shipping. For starters, the region has some of the most dangerous road networks. The increasing use of roads to carry freight has also been found to contribute to road congestion, which in turn causes time delays and wasted fuel. Roads also account for a major share of air pollution within the freight transport sector. Additionally, the excessive use of heavy trucks adds an additional cost burden to governments as a result of additional costs associated with road deterioration, including costs of wear and tear, reconstruction of roads, and rehabilitation of bridges. Governments in SADC are constantly building new roads and rail links. However, overloading by road users, floods, and lack of maintenance have caused roads to deteriorate at alarming rates. Civil unrest and wars in Mozambique, Angola, and the DRC have also caused significant damage to road and rail networks in these countries. Lastly, the negative impacts of the excessive use of road for freight transport in SADC are extended to other harms. For instance, the impacts of road congestion are said to be longer transit times and unreliable transport services, which in turn lead to negative economic effects due to the inefficient delivery of goods and services. The adverse impacts of these has an economic dimension in terms of unattractiveness to foreign direct investors. The setting therefore encourages the visitation of short sea shipping. This study was made possible with funding and support from the Center of Transport Studies and the Namibia Ports Authority.